idols. What Sidatil Arham? And we should keep it strong, the kinship among the people. وَأَنْ يُوحَدَ اللَّهِ And that we unified Allah. وَلَا يُشْرَكَ بِهِ And no one should associate anyone with Allah. I said to him, وَمَنْ مَعَكَ عَلَى ذَلَى وَمَنْ مَعَكَ عَلَى هَذَى Who followed you with this? قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ حُرٌ وَعَبْدْ A free man, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and a slave, Bilal bin Rabah رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ Bilal learned about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Abu Bakr accepted Islam, he asked Rasulullah one question. Ya Rasulullah, what is my duty and responsibility? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your responsibility is my responsibility, and my responsibility is your responsibility. And that responsibility is to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To call people, invite people to Allah. And then he got up. And he brought Uthman bin Affan radiyallahu anhu. Az-Zubair bin Awwam radiyallahu anhu. Abdurrahman bin Auf. Sa'd bin Abi Waqas. He brought them to Islam. And Bilal followed them. Radiyallahu anhum ajma'een. From that day, ya ikhwati fi billah, Bilal had nothing else but to go and see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam secret. Learn from him. Gain from this ilm. Because ilm is power, ya ikhwati fi Allah. Without ilm, we are nothing, especially the ilm of this deen. هو العذب المهند ليس ينبو تصيب به مضارب من أردت كنز خفيف الحمل لا تخاف عليه لصا يوجد حيث كنت يقول يزيد بكثرة الإنفاق من وينقص إن به كفا شددت This is the power of علم But Bilal did not enjoy that freedom And his master learned That is a slave accepted Islam. فَأَقْسَمْ لَأَجْعَلَنَّكَ آيَ لِمَنْ خَلْقَكَ He promised to him that he would make him a lesson for the rest of the slaves. That the rest of the slaves, when they see how Bilal is treated, none of them would accept Islam or think about accepting Islam. So he tied him down. فَقَالَ بِلَال أحد. Allah is one. He lashed him. فَقَالَ أَحَدٌ أَحَدٌ Allah is one. Allah is one. He tied a rough robe around his neck. And he asked the servant and the children to drag him around the city of Mecca. On a pointy sharp rocks on his body. And he starts bleeding from head to toe. And Bilal is saying, Ahadun Ahad. Ahadun Ahad. Ahadun Ahad. Subhanallah, ya ikhwati fillah. His master, Allah to Fadi fight under the sun, placed him a rock on his chest. And Bilal is saying, Ahadun Ahad. And us, In this comfortable life, we live our life and there is no harm that we can complain about. But we're still unhappy. Nobody would come to us and drag us around the city of Toronto. But we're still unhappy. We're not doing the job of the job that they did. We're still unhappy. Al-Khabbab bin Aq radiyallahu anhu witness Abdullah, witness Ammar bin Yasir and his parents being killed Ammar was not killed, but his parents were killed. Al-Khabbab, Khabbab bin Arq, they used to find him alive, put him on charcoals and his body would put it off from the blood that is coming from his body. And then he went with all pain, all agony, all stress. And he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَلَا تَسْتَنْصِرُ لَنَا. I mean, at least ask Allah to relieve us from this punishment. يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَلَا تَدْعُوا لَنَا. Ask Allah to take this hardship on from us. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ بَعْدَ أَنْ أَحْمَرَّ وَجْهَهُ. He said to him, Wallahi, the people before you, a mat will be brought, and a ditch or a grave will be digged, and a hole will be digged for him, and he will be buried in that, except in that hole except his head. And they will bring a metal saw and cut his head into two halves, and that will not stop that individual from believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. But you're rushing. You are complaining for no reason. You are rushing. Subhanallah, ya ikhwati fillah. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, he passed by Bilal being tortured. فَقَالَ يَا أُمَيَّا لَا حَاجَةَ لَكَ فِي جَعْنِي. You have no need for this servant. Sell him to me. Let me take him. فقال أمية خذ لا خير فيه. And Abu Bakr al-Siddiq removed the rock from his chest. And imagine this, يا إخوتي في الله. Bilal is bleeding from head to toe. He was not served anything to eat or drink. He's in pain. And Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu grabs him by the shoulder and he says, Ya Bilal, anta hurrun liwajhillah. You are free for the sake of Allah. Do whatever you do. Imagine, the man is free. At last, finally he's free. What would you do? You will go and search for your lost family. You will go to Yemen where you were born. You may go to Abyssinia and ask for your family. You may go and take care of yourself. But Bilal did not ask any of that. Rather he asked, Aina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Aina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because his love was not fake for Rasulullah. He loved him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَالَ هَيَّ بِنَا. Let us go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when Rasulullah saw the condition of Bilal, he can hardly walk. But Bilal is not in pain. Yes, he may look in a worse shape than you can imagine, but he's not in pain. He's free. He can practice La ilaha illallah. And from that day on, his ultimate job was to serve him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Carry his shoes. Carry his water for wudu. Carry his anazar for wusutra. And he used to think this is the most honorable job that a man can ask for. And Rasulullah made hijrah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he continued with the same job that he used to do in Mecca, in Medina. On one of those days, Abdullah and Umar, two companions radiyallahu anhu, ran to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, we had a dream and we saw an angel teaching us how to call the Adhan. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أين بلال؟ Where is that black Abyssinian serpent?